it's me Anushka. Welcome back to another video from the NIFT series. Today's video is going to be all about the NIFT Mumbai campus and the hostel exclusively. I put up a post on my Instagram story and my YouTube community asking all of you out there to drop your questions regarding the NIFT Mumbai campus and the hostel only. And I received quite a lot of questions, all of which I'm going to be answering today in this video. In case if you're watching me for the first time, then make sure to subscribe to my channel. I make videos on fashion, beauty, lifestyle and fashion education, and I also make dance videos sometimes. And in case you're already a subscriber, then make sure to hit that bell icon right there so that you get notified whenever I put up a new video. And well, without any further ado, let's get started with the video. So the first question is, can you help me know more about this profession, like what stream will you take and why? So, I haven't really chosen a profession yet, but yes, my department is fashion communication. I took fashion communication because I always had an interest towards fashion journalism. I also look forward to writing in a fashion magazine someday. And I have been blogging, like writing fashion articles, since quite a few years now. So, I was really looking forward to this department, fashion communication, because fashion journalism is a major part of this department, and it also has styling and visual merchandising, and I'm really interested in both of these as well. And I never really had any interest in making garments, so fashion design was not for me. So I had this in my mind that I have to take fashion communication, mainly because I am really passionate about writing fashion articles, basically fashion journalism, styling and visual merchandising. Hostel or PG, in terms of money, facilities, which one is cheap? So, about the PGs around that area, I don't really know much about it because I never inquired about any PG. I was staying at the hostel in my first year, that is last year, and I'm going to be staying at the hostel this year as well. The hostel is quite pricey, but then you get a lot of facilities, which is the answer to another question probably, because I saw there's a question like what are the facilities in the hostel. So the hostel has quite a lot of good facilities, like it has a gym and you do not need to pay for it. It has a beauty parlor. It has like a laundry room with lots of washing machines, and you have places to iron your clothes as well. It also provides for like 24/7 hot water for bathing. There are lots of rooms as well, and there are lots of washrooms as well. And the rooms are also really nice, it's very clean. I have been staying in the twin sharing rooms, so it's almost like a hotel, like if you compare it to other government hospitals. It is way too good. You also have a balcony. Last year, the view from my balcony was really nice. This year, I don't know what it's going to be like. But then again, the room was very clean, and every day a maid would come and clean our room. So I think the hostel facilities are really nice. There's also some great security, so in case if your parents are worrying about the fact that whether staying in Mumbai will be secure or not, then do not worry if you're staying at the hostel. You can assure them there's a really great security at the hostel. So with regards to all the facilities that are there in the hostel, I think the price is quite good, and I don't really know about the PGs. I would say the hostel is better, at least for now. How much does it cost for you to stay in Mumbai? Total expense including accommodation and tuition fees. The tuition fees is like what? 1 lakh something per semester, and the hostel fees is like, again, along with the mess fees, it is around 1 lakh per year. So at the starting of the year, you have to pay like what? 2 lakhs something. For more accurate calculations, you can check out the NIFT website and the prospectus. I see a lot of people have been asking me about my monthly expenses, so this is very personal. I cannot share my monthly expenses out here. Monthly expenses differ from one individual to another. Your monthly expense might be very different from what my monthly expense is. But the basic thing is, yeah, Mumbai is quite expensive, so I prefer saving up. Talking about the stationery expenses, it again depends from one month to another. In the first year, which is the foundation year, you're going to have to take a lot of printouts, so I would try to save up in that as well. I prefer looking for alternatives which will cost me a little lesser, but it might be different for you, but you are going to have to bear a little bit of stationery expenses. So this is a question that I cannot give an appropriate or accurate answer to. Next question is it compulsory to bring the parents on all the 3 days of the orientation? You do not need to bring them for all 3 days of the orientation. I think it's only compulsory on the first day of the orientation. How are the seniors in NIFT Mumbai? So the seniors in NIFT Mumbai Mumbai are good. Like most of them are too busy with their own work. I haven't interacted with like all my seniors, but the ones that I have interacted with are really great. Most of them are usually busy with their own work, but once you talk to them, they are really nice. The next question is, can you tell anything about the placements? Recently heard so many bad things about it. So even I read an article on how the NIFT placements were not nice and in fact really bad this year. Most people land up with a good job, not from the campus placements but from doing a good job in the internships that they do during the third year and the fourth year. Most people do not even sit for the campus placements. And also talk about the campus placements, it varies from one year to another. It's not just when it comes to NIFT, but it is the same case for every other college and every other field. So do not worry about that. Just believe in yourself, do your work nicely, and when the time comes, you'll just figure it out. Do not worry. How is the environment and food there? So the environment there is like a combination of everything. It is like every other college environment. I prefer staying busy with my own work. That is just the way I am. But it is different for every other individual. And talking about the food, it starts off as something nice, but then as the year proceeds, it starts getting worse. There's this thing called Feast Sundays where you get like good breakfast and lunch on the first Sunday of every month, but then on that day you don't get evening snacks or dinner, you need to eat from outside. So the Feast Sundays are really nice, but then the hostel food is not that great because they provide like a lot of South Indian food. But this is like a story for every other hostel mess out there. You can ask anyone and they will have to take the same thing. The next question is, do we need to refer to our seniors as ma'am or sir? This doesn't happen in the NIFT Mumbai campus. Also, there is no such ragging. I didn't experience any. The most that they told us to do was like to introduce ourselves in front of everyone. So it's very chill. It's nothing like that. What kind of rooms are available in the NIFT Mumbai hostel? You have AC or non-AC rooms, and you have twin sharing rooms or three sharing, four sharing, six sharing, eight sharing, and a 17 sharing dorm. I stay in a twin sharing non-AC room. Have you gone for any college tour? Say it with a prediction that what place will take you. So last year on the third year for orientation, the college, like the first year students were taken for Mumbai induction. And they took us to places like Marine Drive, Bandstand, and Hanging Gardens. It was quite fun, and I think these are the usual places that they would take you in case if they are planning for Mumbai Darshan this year as well. How's the ambience one could get from NIFT department to NIFT Mumbai? I don't have much idea because this last year I was in the foundation program, and now I'm going to be moving on to my department, which is again fashion communication, not NIFT department. But I know a lot of people, a lot of my friends are from the NIFT department, and I think they are really nice, so I bet the department is also very nice. In NIFT Mumbai, does hostel have limited seat for boys, like 2 digits only? How are we supposed to get done with it? So I don't have much knowledge about the NIFT Mumbai boys hostel, and all I can say is that from what I have heard, the boys hostel is not that good. What things did you pack for your hostel when you came to NIFT Mumbai? For example, casual clothes, traditional, etc. So for this, I'm thinking of making a video because a lot of you have been asking me this question. So soon, I'll be making a video on the things that you should be packing for your first year at NIFT. So I'm not going to answer this question right now. Stay tuned for the video. How are the hostel rules in NIFT Mumbai? Strict or it's okay? And also, since it is in Navi Mumbai, is traveling difficult on weekdays? Yes, traveling is a little difficult on weekdays, like if you want to go to main Mumbai. And also there's a time constraint in the hostel, like you need to get back by 10:30 max, or else a text will be sent to your parents because you need to put in your biometric by 10:30, and the hostel rules are like okay, the security is really nice. So I think I have answered all the questions. In case if I have missed out on any question, which I don't think I have, but in case if I have, you can leave your questions in the comment section below. I try to answer all the questions that you guys put up in the comment section. In case if you liked this video and found this helpful, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up. You can also follow me on my Instagram, Random Plugin. The username is right here. So well, thank you so much for watching this video, and until next time, bye! Thank you.